Let's just start with the generative fill tool, and if you could tell us how in practice it would work and how it would meaningfully change the end product and perhaps create demand for new uses of the software.
Absolutely. Scarlet, thank you for having me on. Today's a big day for Adobe with the introduction of generative technology going into Photoshop for the first time. We actually launched Firefly, which is our core generative capabilities, 7 weeks ago as a standalone capability. So people could create images, they could create text effects. Today, the massive step forward for us and the industry is that we've taken that and we've natively integrated it into our Creative Cloud application, starting with Photoshop first. So now someone working in Photoshop can, as you see on the screen here, start to affect the images and save hours of work simply by using text to help generate and fill information around it. And we do that in a way that leverages all of the authoring capabilities of Photoshop, including its layers, mm-hmm. so that the work enables a lot more iteration, a lot more exploration, and a lot more productivity because of the way people are able to use it in their existing workflows.
Right, and I know that Adobe is all about serving the creative community. I know also that Adobe ignited some anger earlier this year for potentially training AI models on user files by default. I know that that's been resolved, but what did you learn from that episode?
Communication is key. We've never trained on user files that are part of Creative Cloud. We've been incredibly transparent throughout this process. And in fact, I think we've taken industry leading position on this. Everything that we've used to train our models, we have absolute right to use it. So it's, we have the complete origin of that content so that we've been able to be completely transparent with everyone, how our models are trained. We've also been able to, to announce that because we know where the content is coming from, principally Adobe Stock, we are also going to be compensating the contributors for the benefits that we get and the industry gets from the content. So we're very excited about, how this can be positive for creators.
Now, David, I think that incident is a good example of just how sensitive folks are approaching the use of AI in creation of assets. When I think about kind of the impact outside of Adobe of what your customers are using your products for, I have to ask the question that I think a lot of folks are asking these days. When it comes to AI misinformation, when it comes to tools to creating that misinformation, where is the role of folks like yourself in making sure that we don't have kind of AI-generated misinformation out in the world? How is Adobe thinking about what I'm sure will continue to be a tricky issue as generative AI really gets into the hands of people at large?
Yeah, I think we all in the tech industry need to take a very lenient position on working with governments and regulators to address this issue. So our position has been, and we've worked with both the White House and Capitol Hill. We've also been very involved with the EU with their AI Bill of Rights, and we believe that the right approach here is to do something called content credentials. What content credentials effectively does is it's a nutrition label for every piece of content you see online. And we make sure that anything that flows through our products, whether it's the AI generated capabilities of Firefly, or whether it's our core flagship applications like Photoshop, have the provenance or have the origin of all that content in it so that when someone sees it, ultimately on a website, they can go and look at it and say, well, what was this and how was it generated? So they can use their own judgment about whether this is content that they want to depend on or content that they don't trust.
So I spent a lot of time in the social media space. I spent a lot of time with creators and advertisers. They're trying to move really fast. They are looking at things like CapCut, some of your competitors, Canva. There's a slew of new kind of startups who are pushing in and seemingly trying to take some of Adobe's traditional creation business. How are you facing competition from these kind of younger players who are perhaps not providing that digital provenance that you guys are committing to?
Well, first of all, the Adobe core business for creative and our business overall continues to grow. I think we as you probably saw in our last earnings call, we had a great quarter. We beat and then we raised our guidance for the year. So the core machinery continues to grow, both in terms of what we're doing for creative professionals, but also this massive and growing population of creativity for all. Everyone that's part of the creator economy, that are the younger generations and students that are looking to add more content that stands out. So we're benefiting from all of that. At the foundation, we think innovation is key. And we think the way that works is having a set of products from Firefly, which you can use just for fun and enjoy yourself, to Adobe Express, which is perfect for knowledge workers and creator economy, all the way to Photoshop, and then enable everyone to sort of create along that continuum and enable them to work together on that. So we feel very good about the breadth of offerings and the onboarding that users have into those offerings.
Well, speaking of startups, of course, you led the purchase of the design startup Figma not so long ago, and the U.S. government is preparing a lawsuit to potentially block it, and we know the U.K. has already done so. Your CEO has said that you're working to convince authorities that it's not anti-competitive. How's that going? Very quickly.
We're cooperating and sharing all the information that we have with the regulators around the world. Our core belief and continues to be that the substance of the case is that this is an adjacency that's good for the industry and good for consumers. Mm-hmm. We see a lot of potential benefits, and we're confident in the case. And we just have to let the process play out.